Hi everybody. Today is the fourth and final chapter in the programming beats chapters. And this one is called top, bottom, left, right. And what that refers to is the different positions of the pieces of a drum kit and how it's laid out. So for example, the top would be the hats and the cymbals. The bottom would be the kick and the snare and the toms. And right to left is the direction of motion, like if you're starting off with your floor tom, ending with a snare, or vice versa. Then we can use that to create a beat. So for example, a top-down beat will be led with the hats, or the crash, or the ride. A bottom-up will be the other way around, led by the kick. And right to left refers again to the direction that the hits are going to. So let's see what we can make out of that. So I used the same song that I've been using for the past 3 days, and I made up a beat out of three different kits, one of them playing top down, one bottom up, and one right to left. So let's look at each one. The top down is mainly just hats playing together, and it ends with a kick and a snare at playing together. And this is what it sounds like. Another kit, but that's basically kick and snare with a couple of hats halfway through. So let's hear what that sounds like on its own. From the start of it, before adding the right-left bit, I'll put the hats on the right, because I like having them on the right. And keep this in the center. And the right-left one, I'll make it start from the left instead of the right. So let's do that. If we check the right-left one, it's basically all toms, just all toms. And they keep going in this direction, from the floor tom, to the mid, to the high, and then the snare. So let's listen to it on its own. And this one is a 3-bar loop. If you remember a couple days ago, there was a chapter on asynchronous and polyrhythmic loops. So I felt that works really well here. So let's hear it without the other two. So you'll notice it sounds kind of empty without the other two. But once we put all three together, it starts sounding really good. So let's hear that. And this way, I was playing around with the LFO, controlling this hat over here, just to make, you can automate that, it becomes really interesting, so that it doesn't repeat exactly like in two times in a row. Here, the panning changes from right to left, and here in the other way around. So you get a really big sound, a lot of variation. You'll see here that I used other concepts, like the ghost note stuff, the playing around with the timing that is not fixed. And so I hope that these past 4 days will help you make more interesting beats. It certainly has helped me and put a lot of stuff in focus. Anyway, so that's it for today. I'll see you tomorrow. Bye.